Hello friends, my name is Dr. Vikas Dua and I'm a pediatric hematologist, oncologist and a bone marrow transplant physician by profession. So before telling you about sickle cell anemia, I just wanted to tell you briefly about what a pediatric hematologist, oncologist and a bone marrow transplant physician does. So we as pediatric hematologists see blood disorders, any sort of blood disorders, whether it is anemias, thrombocytopenias, thalassemias, sickle cell anemias, aplastic anemia, and we also see malignant disorders like leukemias, brain tumors, sarcomas, bone tumors. And other than these, we do bone marrow transplants. The specific indications for doing a bone marrow transplant in pediatric age groups are like thalassemia, sickle cell anemia, aplastic anemia, relapsed malignancies like leukemias. I'm going to tell you about sickle cell anemia because very many patients come to us from African countries, from northeast part of our own country for treatment of sickle cell anemia for a bone marrow transplant. So what is sickle cell anemia? We need to know about that. Sickle cell anemia is a hereditary disorder in which your red cells are sickle shaped, and because of that it causes blocking of our blood vessels. So when these sickle cell red cells cause the blocking, they can cause painful crisis. The child can have pain in the hands, feet, in the abdomen. Because of the blockage, they can have acute chest syndrome. They may throw a fit, like they can have seizure. They may have stroke because of blockage. They can go to the eye and can cause retinal detachment. They can cause problem to the kidneys. And other than these, they can have affect any other organ of the body. So to diagnose sickle cell anemia, we just need to do a simple blood test that's called complete blood count. And after getting a complete blood count, we can do a test called HPLC. On HPLC, we can easily pick up the patients who have sickle cell anemia. So once you diagnose a patient with sickle cell anemia, we can go ahead with the treatment. What is the permanent treatment for sickle cell anemia? A permanent treatment for sickle cell anemia is a bone marrow transplant. But not each and every patient of sickle cell anemia needs a transplant. There are specific indications of doing a bone marrow transplant, like a patient who has frequent painful crisis, a patient who has acute chest syndrome, a patient who has a history of stroke, a patient who has kidney issues because of sickle cell anemia. So an asymptomatic patient who does not have any problem, just been diagnosed as a case of sickle cell anemia, can be just observed and can live a normal life without a transplant. But if you have any of these problems, what I have just mentioned, then you warrant a bone marrow transplant. So once we are pretty sure that a patient needs a bone marrow transplant, the first thing what we need to do is to do HLA typing of the patient and siblings. If a patient has a complete match, that means once you do a HLA typing, if of all the six loci, the patient is complete match with the sister or brother, then that is the best donor. So there are 25 to 30% chance that a patient can find a complete matched donor from brother or sister. That's called matched sibling donor transplant. And that has got the highest success rate, means 80 to 85% chances of cure by doing a matched sibling donor transplant. Those people who are unfortunate, who don't have a matched sibling donor, what we can do an unrelated donor search, and if we find an unrelated donor from somewhere outside the family, we can take that person as a donor. If that option is also not available, we can search from unrelated cord blood registries, and if we don't find an unrelated cord blood for this patient also, then the last option is to do a half-match transplant. A half-match transplant is a very new technique which has just come in India a few years back. So what is this half-match transplant? That's called haploidentical stem cell transplant. So every patient has a father or a mother. So 50% of the genes comes from father, 50% of the genes comes from mother. So you have at least 50% matched donor in the family. But that is taken as the last resort, because if you have a 50% match, there are increased chances of complications like graft versus host disease, graft failure, increased risk of infections. But those patients who have severe symptoms, like have severe painful crisis, had a lot of history of seizures, stroke, kidney issues, they can opt for a half-match transplant. So in this condition, the father or a mother is taken as a donor, and with this still 50 to 60% patients can be cured of this problematic thing which is called sickle cell anemia. Thank you.